One thing that's threatening New Zealand in the coming weeks to months is that when it starts raining, that area becomes more susceptible than it was before to another landslide. So by knowing where those landslides are, how far they traveled, what the material's made out of, we can make some better predictions about what might happen in the coming weeks after or months after the earthquake. Satellite images give us the regional scale. We can look at the entire event. And then with drones, we can go into these areas that are very difficult, if not impossible, to access otherwise and get very high resolution view of the surface and combine those two data sets together.
The perspective is very, very important. So from the land, you're always looking upwards or straight. From a satellite, you practically look always downwards in the plan view. The drone, you can have all these different oblique views that allow you to better understand what you're seeing.
The main idea of the project in New Zealand is to have a 4D look at the topographic surface of the Earth. By 4D, I mean we're going to get high resolution 3D topography, and then the fourth dimension is how that topography has changed in time. And the biggest change happened during the earthquake itself. But then we also have the opportunity to continue looking, and so we can see smaller scale changes to the Earth's surface. And from that, we're going to learn about how the landslides happen, how the landslides evolve over time, and whether or not they need to be considered a future hazard.